Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a champagne flute with champagne inside. I have seen this kind of design all over Instagram and Facebook, so we're going to give it a go. Let's get cracking. Can I have a glass of champagne, please? So I've got a nail that I've already painted with Serious Black, and I have top coated it with the Urban Graffiti top coat. Before I add any artwork, I am going to buff this nail to make it matte. That's because I'm going to paint on this nail. So we'll use a combination of paint, so we use a polycolour paint, and we'll also use gel polish. So because I'm going to paint on this nail, I need to take off the shine. It'll paint a lot nicer, more flatter and smoother. I'm going to wipe over with some gel residue wipe off solution just to really clean that nail. I've got a sculpting form here, just the backing off it, so I can use that as a palette. You can also use like a bit of tin foil, or a tile is also good. This is just a little bit more disposable. Just going to add a little bit of water. You don't want it too thick, the paint, because you want it to glide on really smooth and fine. And I'm going to start here. So a little bit more paint. We're going to do a champagne flute, which is long.
What's the other kind of champagne glass called? You know, where it's like a bowl.
That's a gin balloon glass.
Because you can have champagne served in either flutes or like a very shallow bowl. Like it's only about that deep.
Oh, like when you have
when they do
a cocktail.
When
they stack it up and they make like a pyramid.
What's that called?
I don't know. I've never actually seen one of them for real life. I've only ever seen it on pictures or films.
Really?
If you want to neaten anything up, you can just damp a brush in acetone and just rub that across and it'll tidy it up for you. Now we're going to do the stem. Tiny little bit of shading and highlighting in that. Then we'll do the top rim. So this is your guide now, because you're going to fill the champagne flute with some gel. I've got two gel polishes here. I've got this glitter one, which I think is like a champagne colour. Do not drink that. It's not champagne. It will not get you drunk. And then I've got this pinky one, because I wanted to make it look a bit like pink champagne. Take some of this gold pop it on my little palette. I'm going to do the same with the pink. Take your detailing brush, pick it up. You want the majority of it at the bottom of the glass. Then we're going to start to bring that up and sort of fade it. So you're just tickling those glitter particles up as if they are bubbles floating up the glass. Then we're going to use the pinky one and go over the top of that. Just to make it look a bit like pink champagne. I like pink champagne. I like gin, but I like pink champagne a lot.
What does gin have something to do?
It's just alcohol.
Oh, right. I don't really like champagne. I love red wine, but I'm not a big fan of champagne.
No.
But I love a bottle of Verve every now and again.
Oh, darling, will you, darling?
But that's about it, really.
I'm going to pop that into the lamp and cure that. I'm going to top coat this now, but this isn't the last bit we're going to do. I just want to top coat everything in so I know it's sealed and it will actually last. This would be nice if you're celebrating a birthday, I think. I've told you I'm going to Vegas to celebrate my best friend's birthday.
You're talking to me or the...
I'm telling everybody.
Right. Yes, you've told me several times today and yesterday and the day before.
Yeah.
And last year.
Just in case you hadn't... You might have forgot, you see.
Oh, right.
Okay. Just going to pop that into the lamp. The pink stone actually looks really nice with this design. What I'm going to do now is take the mega gloss and it's... What I'm going to do now is take the mega gloss. It's okay to use the mega gloss over the top of this because it's going to be a small amount. I know you guys might be thinking, but it's gel polish! You can't put mega gloss over the top of gel polish. You can if it's only a small amount. You wouldn't want to cover the whole nail. So I'm using it because it's thicker than the Urban Graffiti top coat. And we're using this to make it raised. So we're going to take it and do the shape of the glass. To make it more 3D. Now I'm going to cure that first. One of the Nail Pro competitions in America, the theme was cocktails. And I did loads of glasses, all different kinds of glasses, like crystal cut glasses with all different cocktails in. And I did like this lady in the middle. I'll find a picture and we'll put it in somewhere. And I loved doing it. I loved doing the glasses. So this is not the first time I've done glasses. However, that was just hand painted. It wasn't 3D. What I'm going to do now is do the stem. So just float down. And do the base. What I'm going to do now to finish this off is add a little bit of bling. 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 And I'm going to do that by using the mega gloss to just hold them on.
Someday I think you're going to go, I'm just going to add a little bit more or nothing at all because it's perfect as it is.
Oh, it would be nice. But it wouldn't be perfect without the bling. These are our AB stones.
Aurora Borealis.
Aurora Borealis. These are my favourite coloured stone. Yeah. I just love it. I think they're absolutely stunning.
Have you ever seen the Aurora Borealis?
Never seen it in person.
Oh, you need to go to Iceland.
I know I do.
I mean, you can see it from if you go far enough north, especially during the summer. But yeah, Iceland's just wicked.
Can you only see it at certain times of the year?
What it is, do you know what it is? So.
No.
It's radiation from the sun bouncing off the magnetosphere of the Earth.
The watersphere?
The magnetosphere.
I'm going to act like I know what that means.
So it's being deflected by our atmosphere.
Right.
You know how the we've got the poles? Not Polish people, as in the poles.
Yeah.
Like North Pole, South Pole.
Yeah.
So that's like different ends of a magnet. So they create a magnetic field around the Earth. No?
Yeah, I'm agreeing.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what happens is when that radiation, solar radiation bounces off it, it creates these amazing colours.
I can't believe that that's how it is. That's amazing. And I did think that somebody said to me you could only see it at certain times of the year.
No. It depends what activity that the sun's kicking out, because we always have a magnetic field around us.
Yeah.
And if the sun's kicking out a lot of radiation and it's bouncing off the thing, so it just depends on what's happening in the sun, really.
You are such a geek. Did I learn this at school once upon a time?
Probably, yeah, but I mean, it was a long time ago, that.
And for you? How did you remember that? I did like school. I did attend.
Was it fun going to school on a horse and carriage?
Oh my God, you're so rude. I've got enough stones now, I'm happy. I did think about putting some there as well. Yeah, we'll just put some there dead quick. Now I'm happy. So you can see that's raised. And we have some pink champagne.
A never empty glass.
Yeah. Well, that's the kind of glass I like, a never empty glass. I am not an alcoholic. I am an ale artist. Hey, guys, hope you've enjoyed that video. That was inspired by what I've seen on Facebook and Instagram. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram as well. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.